After spending time with the owners of Shetty Lunch Home and learning of the tips and tricks that go into making the chicken ghee roast and kane masala fry, in this episode I enjoy a sumptuous lunch. From savoring the juicy ghee roast and kane masala fry, I also dig into an enormous seafood thali with nearly 10 delicious seafood dishes. To know what I tasted, make sure you watch this episode till the very end. So after all the time that I've spent in the kitchen with the owners cooking these dishes, I really feel like I deserve this big lunch. So of course, we have the chicken ghee roast in all its glory. Kane masala fry, the dish that was invented by Shetty Lunch Home. And this is a beautiful seafood thali. The thali that is groaning under the weight of all these dishes. For starters, we have a prawn curry. So, you know, those tiny prawns, the small prawns, I think these prawns pack the most flavor. The squid ghee roast, or they call it bondus here in Mangalore, the bondus ghee roast. And happy taste one. You know, the squid is not rubbery at all, it's just beautifully cooked. Clam, the marwai sukka. These tiny clams, you know, with all the coconut and all the goodness of the masala. Beautiful. And then we have the anjal, the sear fish. I've got the buttermilk here. Then I have a very interesting etti chutney or prawn chutney made from tiny shrimps. We have the mango pickle and of course the customary vegetable. So this is how Mangaloreans balance, eat a balanced meal. So you've got all this beautiful seafood and then you have your vegetables. Just in case the doctor asks you, yes, I have my vegetables too. I think I'll begin with the chicken ghee roast first. What's important is to take all that masala. I think that masala is where all the goodness is. The beautiful aspect of the chicken ghee roast here is that all the ingredients have come together so harmoniously well. You can taste the chili at the back. You can taste a bit of the coriander spike. But it's all beautifully come together with the ghee. So let's now taste the chicken with the masala. The chicken has beautifully absorbed the masala. The fact that the chicken is cooked for an hour in this masala makes all the difference. This is not a jhatka dish. This is not a dish where the masala is cooked separately and the chicken is cooked separately and they're just added together last minute. This is a dish in which both the chicken and the masala cook together to create the magic that is the Shetty Lunch Home chicken ghee roast. With all due respect to all these other dishes, if you had to just give me this chicken ghee roast and the neer dosa, that would be a happy lunch. As you can see, the kane has roasted a bit more on the tawa. So all the masala, all the goodness of the masala, all the goodness of the spice has really gone into the kane. Let's taste the magic. Of the kane masala fry. Small bone. I think the secret to the spectacular dishes here are the spices, are the masalas, are the way they're kind of blended together. I think that comes with years and years of doing these spectacular dishes over and over again. Brilliant, brilliant stuff. So, you can see the buttermilk even is nice and pale green because of the fresh coriander that has gone into it. Delicious. And just what you need, just what you need in the Mangalore heat. So I'm now tasting the anjal fish fry. Cooked in the same masala, but tastes a whole lot different. The anjal is a strong flavored fish. It's got all its oils. You want to eat it with the skin. That's really where what the flavor of that fish is. You know, there's some people who don't like the skin, but I think the skin is where all the taste, all the flavor is. But personally, between the anjal and the kane, I think I'm more partial to the kane. I think that's my Mangalore gene speaking. I just feel that this kane masala fry is a super hit of a dish. We'll go back to the bondus ghee roast. It's cooked just perfectly. You know, sometimes bondus or squid, if you overcook it, it gets a little rubbery. And if you undercook it, you really can chew on it. But this is just cooked just right. You can, it's not chewy at all. It has a bite that squid needs to have. It's not soft and mushy. And it's again soaked in the masala beautifully well. The Mangalore boiled rice, which is traditionally eaten here. You know, this masala, you can just eat it just by itself. Just the rice and the masala, and maybe a little bit of the etti chutney or the shrimp pickle. So you have that heat from the ghee roast masala, and you have that slightly salty, pungent flavor of the shrimp. You know, I expected the shrimp to be drier, but it's not. It's actually got a little bit of moisture still there, which kind of makes for a nice bite. So it's a small shrimp, as you see, they've been just dried with the shell, but there's still a fair bit of moisture. Last, but certainly not the least, is the etti curry. Etti is prawn in Kannada and Tulu, so I want to taste a bit. Loads of curry, that's the secret. A dish, first taste only the curry, because you should find all the flavors in the curry. Delicious. This is a very traditional Mangalore style prawn curry, and you can taste the roasted masala, you can taste all those flavors come together. It's very easy to overcook prawns. Either it becomes too mushy or it becomes rubbery. But this prawn is just right. You can, you know, you have the bite of the prawn intact, and it's neither rubbery nor mushy, and it's held the masala. You can taste the roasted masala. Shetty Lunch Home in Mangalore is a must visit for anybody who wants to understand what it truly takes to keep alive the spirit of a great culinary tradition.